What's up guys, Jeff Cavalier, ATHLEAN-X.com. Today we're gonna talk about why stretching is killing your gains. And to demonstrate it, I wanna start by having us all stand up and do a set of 15 degree ankle dorsiflexion, 130 degree knee flexion, 110 degree hip flexion, lower lumbar spine stabilizing, scap retracting, forward eye gazes. Okay, with maybe 300 pounds. You don't know what that is? See, the thing is, that's just a squat. But see, your body doesn't store that information that way. Your body recognizes a squat as a squat, and you learned it from a very young age, and it's called an engram. And an engram is a stored motor pattern that allows us to be neurologically efficient so that when I have to squat, like let's say when I have a muscle marker in my pocket that I drop, I don't think about going through every component that I just listed out for you. But in order to get down there, yes, all that stuff is happening for me to go down here and squat, but instead instantly my body knows, get down to the ground, pick that thing up and go. So what happens is when you start to do static stretching, holding stretches for 30 seconds, 45 seconds, some people do them for a minute and a half, prior to either training or going out and competing in something, you're asking for trouble, because what you're trying to do is you're in an effort to do a good thing, you're causing your body to have to readapt on the fly, and it doesn't really do a great job of it, especially early on in your training. So it compromises your ability to do this. So if I were to do that before a squat, and I stretch all the things out, because guys do everything, they'll stretch out their quads, and they're gonna stretch out their hamstrings, right? They're gonna stretch out their hips before they do a squat, even up their body, because they know they gotta get their shoulders back in order to grab the bar. They go through this whole process, and when they step under the bar, the body knows a squat based on what your ability to do that squat is on an everyday basis. Now, with this temporary increase in length that I've caused by disrupting it through my static stretching, now when I step under the bar, maybe even if I was stretching my forearms out a little bit, just because people do everything before they squat. Now when I go in and I grab, I could actually turn a back squat or high bar squat into more of a low bar squat just because I have more flexibility here through my forearms, at least temporarily. Right, and if I go and squat there, that's gonna definitely disrupt my motor pattern. If my hips are a little bit looser and I go down now in the squat, when I go down a little bit lower than I'm used to, while it's not a bad thing, I just am not used to that. So now when I'm trying to, my body's trying to say, wait, is he squatting? Is that engram that I have stored? Because it doesn't match up exactly. There's differences here. And it spends all of its time trying to match up the differences between what it's experiencing now versus what you have stored. And neurologically, you become inefficient. The effort is being spent there rather than maximizing your strength and performance here. And that's where your lift is compromised. So while is static stretching bad? No, static stretching is a great thing because ultimately it leads to increased muscle length and flexibility that's going to benefit you in the weight room, just not right now, not before your workout. And I'm gonna tell you how you could do it if you demand and insist on doing that, but it's not really what we're looking for. I'd rather give you a better way to do it. Anybody that's played golf can experience the same thing. If I were to go and swing, I have a golf swing. That's what my body has stored, is a golf swing. Okay, back and then through, there's my swing. But now if I spend all my time static stretching before I go play golf, when I step up for the first tee, you probably experienced this yourself if you played any length of time, all of a sudden, the backside of my shoulders here is a lot more loose than it usually is. So instead of getting to here before I initiate the up part of my swing here, now I'm able to go back even further. But that changes what's demanding here at my hip in order to stabilize the swing. So everything is thrown off, and I spend the first four holes trying to recapture my ability to match up what it is I'm trying to do with what my body knows is a golf swing. So I might throw away four holes, and if I'm competing in golf, that's more than enough to screw up your whole round. So finally, I'll give you one more example here. If I have a bench press, and I spent all my time static stretching on my chest, and I've shown you guys some really good static stretches to differentiate between pec minor and pec major, and they're important, but just not to be done now before I get to here and do a set of bench press, because now with this increased flexibility, I wind up drifting. My arms aren't in the same stored motor pattern. I can't be as neurologically efficient here and then focus my effort on power and strength development, which are both neurologically driven. Instead, I'm trying to find and match up that stored pattern. And even just a little bit of variance here can change things. When we static stretch, guys, we're temporarily causing a length-tension relationship and a difference in the cross-bridging of the actin and myosin inside your muscle that helps to create a contraction. So even if it's just a little bit lengthened versus the normal, we're trying to reestablish what's normal. So what would you do if you insisted on doing static stretching before you trained? Well, you better spend some time now reestablishing what's normal. So what I mean by that is you go through, before you start your training, you got to go through and you have to start to do all, I believe, reintegration of these motor patterns by doing the exercises you're going to do that day. Two or three sets of each one, exploring the new ranges of motion that you've been gaining through your static stretching with lighter weights. That could take you an extra 15 or 20 minutes, but I believe it's necessary if your goal for that day is to do anything where we're improving your strength, especially. So the alternative is to spend your time instead doing a quick warm-up and then doing an active warm-up, right? Using dynamic stretching activities to get yourself ready, not hanging out and prolonged stretching for any length of time, but doing dynamic stretches for those same muscle groups, and then spending one or two or three sets doing the first exercise you're gonna do that day using a nice steady warm-up progression without tiring yourself out, just to sort of groove that move and then go get ready and do your workout. But if you spend any more time than that doing all your static stretching, in the long run, I promise you, your strength gains are going to be limited by that, and ultimately your size gains as well, because you can't get the most out of your workouts because your body is simply mismatched and the neuroefficiency that you created in the first place is being interfered with and screwed up. So guys, I hope you found this video helpful. In the meantime, if you're looking for a program that puts it all together step by step, we tell you when to do the right stretches at the right time. Head to ATHLEAN-X.com, get our ATHLEAN-X training programs. In the meantime, if you found the video helpful, leave your comments and thumbs up below. Let me know what you want me to cover in a future video, and I'll do my best to do that for you in the days and weeks ahead. All right, see you soon.